Have you ever wondered what your drawings would look like if they came to life? Well, wonder no more, because the team over at Meta AI came out with a really cool and interesting tool that'll take your drawings and bring them to life. It's called Animated Drawings. Let me show you what it's all about. So Animated Drawings is a new open source project that Meta AI just recently released that can take any drawing, any doodle, and bring it to life, doing fun and kooky little things like waving hi, dancing, and other little pre-programmed things. I thought that this was really cool and I wanted to try it out, but I'm not very skilled at drawing, so I thought, why not just get dall-e to draw something for me? So I jumped over to Bing and I went to the image creator and I played around with dall-e to get a nice little drawing to show up. So here's the drawings that I got, giving the description of children style drawing, white background with the goose spreading its wings. For animated drawings to be most effective, you need to make sure to have a white background, good solid colors, and simple shapes. This one seemed to have the simplest lines and shapes, so let's go and use this one. Next, I hopped over to the animated drawings demo website. You can get to it by going to sketch.metademolab.com and you'll see this page. Let's get started. On the first page, they give you a checklist of things to go by. We've already went through a couple of these about the drawings, but then also just to make sure not to put any personal identifiable information on here, because they are going to be using the data that uploaded to help train the model. And then in case you have no drawing skills at all, or you just wanted to test it out, there are a couple of sample uploads you could use to do the drawings. Well, we have our own, so let's get to uploading. Let's select our photo. Look at our beautiful goose. Next. And there's going to be a disclaimer about your uploads going to be used to help train the AI. Well, let's agree to it because it's pretty awesome. The next step, we got to make sure to put to crop only the image we want. So let's adjust the box a little bit. I think that's good. Now for the next part, we need to make sure to separate the character from the page. Now we go about that by highlighting and removing certain sections that we don't want to be part of our character for when it starts animating. We have a rough outline of our drawing here, but we want to make sure to include the body and everything else in here. If not, it's just gonna grab the outer edge. So let's make sure to do that. Let's select the drawing tool and let's go around and let's pick a nice fat one. And let's make sure to fill in all of the parts here so that it all comes through when we are animating this guy. This will be the part that takes the longest for you, depending on how much of the drawing it can automatically pick up. Let's make sure to fill in the body. And if at any time you mess up, you can always click the undo button. We don't want all that. Make this bigger. Try to get all of that torso in there. Try to get the head in there. All right, I think that's good. After you're done setting the mask, click next. And now we go to setting up the joints for the animation. You can follow the checklist of the things to do. But each little bullet point here says exactly where each dot should be. So this should be the right wrist. Sure. The elbow. Let's put the elbow right here so we can have a nice little joint. So like that. Put the wrist up there. And then the right shoulder. Let's put the joint here and there for the left shoulder. And then the right hip. Let's put the hips down here where the feet are, the right knee right in the center, the ankle all the way at the bottom, and we'll just keep it right through here. Make sure it looks good. And then You got to make sure to mark the eye, left eye, the right eye is hidden, but it's right there. The right ear is probably going to be somewhere up here too. The left ear is not marked, but we'll just say it's like right here. And then the center of the head is right there. Looks a little weird, but we'll see what it looks like once we go to the next step. Click next. And now, given the mask, the joints, it can start animating it. And check, take a look at that. So we got a nice little fun one of it walking around. And there's plenty of little animations to do, so we could go. Let's take a look and let's poke around with some of these. Now that is pretty darn cool. If I do say so myself, look at it, do a little dance. Who would have thought that a simple little drawing could turn into this? Look at this beautiful dance. You can go in and try to fix it in case you didn't get the joints right or the masking right. And then you can enlarge this to take a look at it. You can click share here. On Mac, clicking the share button brought up the OS native share dialog. So it ended up being a little bit weird for me to try to get hold of the asset. The other way I was able to get to download this, because now this is a video, you can click on the full expand, click on the bullet points, and from here you can click download. And then that will go and download your little video of your person dancing or whatever they're deciding to do. So check that out. And you can see right here by doing the masking, since I wasn't precise, you could see the kind of fuzziness around the different joints. So if you wanted to be very, very detailed with the masking, you go through and with very finely draw all the way around it to make sure to not get all the artifacts around in case there's a lot of noise around your drawing itself. So it's really, really easy to animate anything. And if you're a developer and looking to actually use this, you can hop on over to Facebook Research GitHub page for the animated drawings, where they actually have detailed instructions on how to set this up on your computer and generate animated figures using either their built-in example code, or you can go through the configuration and animate your own custom drawings, do more advanced things like combining drawings together into one whole image that's dancing. Or adding a background to it so it's not just a white background. You can do a lot more. They have instructions for you how to do it on the GitHub page. So check it out if you actually want to have a little bit more fun animating drawings. Hopefully you like this video. If you end up creating anything interesting, please do link it in the comments below, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.